All right, well, there has never been a worse time to be a man.
Tell me about it.
Really?
Yeah, according to a controversial new book, apparently men are being ridiculed, abused and exploited and have become second-class citizens. Mm. And guess what? It's all women's fault.
Well, by process of elimination, it would have to be, wouldn't it?
No, this is true.
Do you know what men need to do? They need to grow a set, really.
Peter Lloyd is the author of Stand By Your Manhood and he joins us live from London. Thank you very much for joining us. Jeez, mate, where to start? You seem to be really angry in your book. What is it exactly that you have against women?
Nothing at all. I absolutely love women. I have to say, this may surprise you, but my mother is a woman. And, you know, I have three wonderful sisters who I love, but nobody ever is honest with men about the real world. And so, you know, we've had books like The Female Eunuch and How to Be a Woman by Caitlin Moran, and I just thought it was high time that us men had our version.
You say that women spend a lot of time looking for Mr. Right. They're very critical. You actually reckon blokes shouldn't get married. Why not?
Yeah, I do. Well, I mean, if I'm honest, marriage is a raw deal. It's a contract, and when it goes wrong for men, they often lose their home, they often can't see their children, they lose half of their fortune, and it can just be really psychologically damaging. I just think, have a great relationship, go for it, pursue love and everything, but just don't get married. It's a contract you don't need.
Oh, Peter, as a happily married woman for 11 years, I'd have to disagree with you. And really, how can you say men have been hard done by? I mean, what evidence do you really have to back that up?
Look, I know it sounds oxymoronic, but bear with me. It's like when somebody first tells you about infinity. You can't quite take it in at first. You have to keep thinking about it, but it's true. I've studied lots of empirical data and, you know, from school, the school system is failing boys. Men are a minority at universities.
The
life what expectancy
university?
Gap. All universities, most universities have men as a minority group.
But they end up earning more later in life in their careers. They end up being on the boards of more companies. They end up running more countries. So it sort of seems a bit oxymoronic, as you put it, that you guys are being oppressed.
Well, look, it's true, but, you know, looking at who runs, you know, boardrooms and companies is only one way of measuring, you know, how equal society is. If you look at the heads of families, it's women
really
who hold
It
is oppression, really. I mean, it might not be the kind of oppression that we're used to seeing and hearing, but it's absolutely real.
Hold on, ladies. Give us a go. You've had a pretty good run. More men are incarcerated, more men kill themselves, more men die at war, more men are homeless. What's the problem with men?
Well, I think the big difference is that men have... gender roles have changed so much in the last 50 years, but men are still programmed to be used on their utility. So men are considered disposable, and feminism, for all its, I mean, it's done some wonderful things, but at the same time, it's really kind of, you know, ignored a lot of men's issues, and they've just worsened over 50 years. So while women's liberation has kind of, like, gone like this, men's lifestyles have kind of gone like that. And all I'm saying in the book is, I'm not blaming women for these problems, but I'm saying, feminism, oi! It's time we, like, started sharing the platform here.
Peter, do you have a girlfriend?
No, I don't. I'm single.
Funny.
Peter, in all seriousness, can I ask, how have you actually been oppressed by women? Like, has there ever been a time in your life where you think, you know what, those, you know, darn cotton-picking women have got one up on me, you know, has it ever happened? Because I don't think it's ever happened to me. I don't think it's ever really happened to anyone I know.
Well, I mean, that is the common misconception, but so many of these things are so insidious. I mean, here in the UK, it's depressing to talk about, but male suicide is at an all-time high. It's at a 15-year high. And I know we're kind of joking about it here, but there are some really serious issues that are affecting men.
Are you saying they're killing themselves because of women? Or they're killing themselves because of feminism?
Well, I mean, I think we have to be realistic here. I mean, it's a very complex issue, but certainly one of the things that is a contributing factor, I'm sure, is the constant denigration of men, like this, that casual, fashionable man bashing we see all the time. I mean, I can take a joke, but it's relentless, and I think after a while...
One of the real problems with youth suicide, and particularly young men killing themselves, is that it's all taking place in rural and regional areas. They're not exactly hotbeds of university feminism, are they?
Well, I wouldn't say that was true. I mean, only 2 weeks ago I had to go to the memorial of a friend who killed himself, and he was a doctor at one of London's best hospitals. So it's absolutely not just taking place in rural areas. And, you know, even if it were, feminism and this kind of man-bashing is so pervasive in the media, it's everywhere, you can't escape
but
it.
People say it's easy
to be a man. I always say try it.
But is being pro-women really being anti-men? And after so long at the top of the tree, I mean, it's only been really 30, 40 years that women have started to find equal footing. I mean, is it more that you're just kind of getting a bit annoyed that your place at the top of the tree is being challenged?
No, crikey, I was never at the top of the tree. My book is edited by a woman. All the experts I cite in the book are almost all women, because this isn't about men versus women. I'm not interested in that. You know, I love women, I respect them, I want them to be equal. It's exciting that we're on the eve of possibly America's first female president. But this isn't about men versus women. This is about unequal versus equal. If you look at men's health spending in Australia, I think men's health ranked 36th in the priority list. That is absolutely atrocious when our life expectancy gap is huge and it's increased massively over 100 years. No politician or any government body is doing anything about that. I mean, that to me does not sound like we are living, you know, the life of Riley, you know, basking in privilege. It's just not true.
Can't we just all get along?
Yes, let's do it. What? Together, like, you know, let's make
pretty,
a difference.
I'm pretty sure hospitals treat people based on who's about to die soonest rather than what gender you are, but anyway.
Well, look, it's a very controversial and a fascinating new book. Obviously, it's provoking a lot of talk, a lot of debate. Peter Lloyd, thank you very much for joining us and chatting about it. Certainly gets people talking, that's for sure.
Thank you for letting me talk about my manhood on live television.
No, it's all right. There aren't enough male voices in the media. I'm glad you get to have your say. So we're going to find out what...